Audio Jungle. Audio Jungle. Audio Jungle.
A former New York City Uber driver who was arrested at John F. Kennedy Airport in 2019 on his way to Afghanistan was planning to join the Taliban and kill Americans, according to prosecutors. In the opening statements of the trial, which began on Wednesday, prosecutors told the Manhattan Federal Court that Delaware Mohammed Hossein, a 36-year-old from the Bronx, was about to board a plane to Thailand with an ultimate destination of Afghanistan and the Taliban before his plan was foiled at JFK Airport in 2019. Hossein now faces terrorism charges for attempting to provide material support for acts of terrorism over his alleged plot to join the extremist group in Afghanistan, and could be handed decades in prison if convicted. Wasn't just any other traveler. He was on a mission to Afghanistan to join the Taliban and kill Americans, and he was on his way. Assistant U.S. Attorney Ben Schreer said in his opening statements, Schreer said Hossein planned to go from Thailand to Afghanistan and they had already bought supplies to survive in the country. Meanwhile, Hossein's attorney presented his client as a wannabe playboy who was looking to board the flight to Thailand to pursue women while his family were left at home. Hossein, who was born in Bangladesh before emigrating to the US and New York City, was arrested with a variety of personal care items, designer jeans and fragrances in his bag. The defense and the prosecution traded competing theories on Hossein's true intentions, with each suggesting the other's tale was a cover-up story. His attorney Andrew Dalak described Hossein as an Uber driver sick of his dead-end job and despairing of his finances and home life who was simply desperate to fly abroad and live a bachelor lifestyle. Hossein's bag was chock full of lotions, creams, perfumes and designer clothing that he had intended to use to charm women when he landed, according to Hossein's attorney. These are items of a wannabe playboy, he said. The day before he was arrested, he asked one of his accomplices, who was in fact an undercover FBI agent, to pick up some extra hair gel, condoms and lubricant before he left, hardly the ingredients for a radical Islamist he had, Dalak scoffed. However, Schreer alleged that Hossein was simply buying these items as a ruse through federal agents of his scent, and claimed the FBI had a voice recording of Hossein declaring that he wants to kill non-Muslim Americans before he dies. According to the New York Post, Hossein was in possession of $10,000 when he was arrested, which Schreer said was to secure extra supplies for the Taliban. The former taxi driver had allegedly told undercover informants that his frequenting of bars and strip clubs was a method to fool law enforcement into thinking he was a party animal who would not conduct himself as a strict Muslim and Taliban fighter should. Hossein reportedly read Al-Qaeda literature that gave instructions on bomb making, and Schreer alleged that the ex-Uber driver wanted to carry out an attack at a NASA military installation but ultimately pulled out because he didn't think he could kill enough people. But Hossein's attorney claimed that his jihadist aspirations were in fact an act and the product of Hossein's wild imagination. It was the warrior act that was the cover story, Dalak said. The trial, which got underway yesterday at Manhattan Federal Court, is expected to continue for several weeks.